Hello to the world and to the kingdom citizens. I greet you in the precious holy name of Yeshua Messiah, Yeshua HaMashiach, who said in his word, John 8:32, and ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Hi, I am Dr. John Curry, ambassador, Pan-African, and welcome to the kingdom of heaven on earth. If you want to follow this podcast, please subscribe to JC Global Embassy TV One. Ring the bell and hit the thumbs up button. Today's message is entitled, A Weak and Divided Africa Demands Great Leadership Through Great Management Skills. A Weak and Divided Africa Demands Great Leadership Through Great Management Skills. When we look at the continent of Africa and all of its great exploits have done long during the time of antiquity and during the time of Kemet and the Nubian civilizations, we can see that Africa has already declared her greatness on the world by establishing world civilization while other nations were still living in caves. But since that time, we're now faced with a new enemy, and that enemy has came to destroy Africa, and that enemy formed itself in the time of 1884. And this was when the European nation decided to come together, and they held a Berlin-Brussels conference of the Congo. And they decided to come together in order to come over to colonize Africa. And in the process of colonizing Africa, they not only colonized the land, but they colonized the minds of those Africans. And as a result, Africa is still in the process of decolonizing her mind as well as decolonizing her civilization. You see, the Europeans and the other nations, such as China and France and Russia, Great Britain, and all of those European nations, and the West, the United States, feel that the only way they can continue to exist is by keeping Africa underdeveloped. And as long as Africa is underdeveloped, the other nations, the European nation, as well as the West, China and France, and all of those ones that come together, they know they would thrive and be what they need to be. So they send money to those, what I call some African leaders that are power struck. They make sure they have the money and power, and they give them guns, and basically to cause them to be a repressive regime in order to keep African people behind for another 50 to 100 years. But God has given me a word for Africa. You see, Africa is the greatest continent in the world, second to none, and everybody know it. Africa is the most diverse continent in the world. Most diverse people with more than 3,000 to 4,000 languages, 54, soon to be 55 nations. Africa has everything that the world wants and the world needs in order for the world outside of Africa to exist. It is important for the world to see Africa as weak and divided, which demands great leadership through great management skills. So I want to talk to you this morning about understanding the difference, understanding what Africa is going through, understanding what Africa must do in order to reclaim her glory as she did during the days of antiquity. The first thing I want to look at is that from the Pan-African past of 1912 and all of the conscious Black leaders on the continent of Africa and throughout the diaspora, who was doing a great work and believed that Africa was one nation in the world, one people in the world. It's important for us to understand that these Black leaders, these Pan-Africans in 1912, believed that if you're Black, wherever you are, all over the world, Africa is your home. Now, we know the original name for Africa is Al-Kabilan, meaning the land of the Blacks. But in this process, I want you to understand that Pan-Africanism says that no matter where you are in the world, no matter where you are not on the continent, not only throughout the diaspora, roughly 250 million strong, that if you're Black, you are African and you came from the continent. Now, we know the sub of that is that everybody came from the continent, but they don't want to identify with Africa unless they're coming over to rob her and steal everything that the continent has. So I just want to get that out the way. And through the independence of the Gold Coast, now known as Ghana in 1957, led by Kwame Nkrumah, who transformed the country into a republic with himself as president for life. Now, what makes that important is that the Pan-Africanism from Marcus Mosiah Garvey, then to Kwame Nkrumah, and we can go on with many other Black African Pan-Africans, they had the idea that Africa was for the Africans, just like Europe is for the Europeans and China and Asia is for the Asian. So Africa is for the Africans. And that type of thought should still be in play even to this day. So when they, the Gold Coast, which is now Ghana, received her independence led by Kwame Nkrumah in 1957, there was other countries that also found their independence, such as Guinea became independent from France in 1958. And it's important for us to know that Africa independence in trying to decolonize the mind is recent. We're talking recent history, basically 65, maybe 70 years ago. It's important for us in the diaspora to know that what we went through in the 1960s and 1950s under segregation and changing those laws and then integration that came in, Africa is now going through right now. Africa is in a struggle trying to decolonize her mind as well as trying to get those colonial people out of Africa. And some have basically went in like ants and dug a trench in the continent, such as in South Africa and other countries around Africa. They dug in like a trench and they're still managing and manipulating Africa from the inside out. In the past, the thought was one Africa, one currency, one army, and one love for Africa, as well as one love for Black people all over the continent. But today we see something just a little bit different. So the question is still, a weak and divided Africa demands great leadership through great management skills. So the leadership that Africa has must demand, must move with great leadership and management skills. You see, the median ages of the Africans in Africa right now is 19.7 years old. It is by far the youngest continent in the world with the greatest wealth in the world. This is why Africa must have great leadership, and that leadership must come through great management, with great management, in order to put the continent in position of power by 2063. Africa, I believe, has a God problem. And that God problem is that until Africa totally submit herself to God, God will continually to allow her enemies to punish her. So that's why I believe it's a God problem, is that God is looking for Africa to submit to him because he's the one that can bring her out, bring her through, and put her in the position where she need to be. Africa leaders are being whooped by God and being whooped by our enemies over on the continent, simply meaning that Africa leaders must be transformed and put away all wickedness and all trying to take advantage of the people so that God can move on the continent and bless the continent like I believe God always wanted to do. It's important. You see, so Africa must train leaders to lead through self-discipline. They must lead through self-discipline. They must train the leaders to be true leaders and train them to be able to lead from the inside out. See, a true leader will lead from the inside out. He know who he is. She know who she is. So when the leaders in Africa begin to do that and have great leadership through great management skills, we'll be able to see in Africa that the world will be shocked that what God has done with those leaders and caused them to strive. You see, these leaders have this self-imposed discipline. They don't have to have the people discipline them or making them be disciplined. They have self-imposed discipline on themselves, on the inside. In essence, a true leader has the ability to integrate, reconcile, and balance the needs of the people before they think of themselves. I want to say that again. True leadership knows how to integrate the laws, integrate what's going on the continent. They know how to reconcile. They know how to balance the needs of others, meaning the people, before they think of themselves. These are the leaders that Africa needs. Africa needs leaders that want to help the people rather than help themselves. Discipline is the root of leadership. It will attract people to you. A true vision for Africa will demand discipline. It is leaders that will create that vision. The question would be, what is the vision of Africa? What is the vision of the continent? What do Africa want to become? Now, we've heard one currency, we've heard one army, we've heard one United States of Africa. We've heard all of these great ideas, but it takes leadership with great management skills. And how does that come? That comes through putting people in position that they're not thinking about themselves, but they're thinking about the people of Africa. The Word of God tells us in Proverbs 29 and 18, it says, where there is no vision, the people perish. But he that keepeth the law, happy is he. So in other words, people need to see the direction where Africa is going. They don't need to see the direction of where the president or one of the presidents of Africa is going, riding around in limousines, only taking care of their own family, only doing the stuff that's going to make them look good. A true leader is more concerned about the people. He's more concerned about what can we get for the people? What can we do to help the people? Remember, Africa comes across as a weak and divided Africa, which demands great leadership through great management skills. Africa needs leaders with great leadership and know how to manage the affairs of the continent. I believe it was Kwame Nkrumah who laid out a vision for the continent of Africa, but the people was divided on how to carry it out. The people was divided on the vision. Kwame basically believed that Africa need to be for the Africans and that Africa need to know how to support herself, know how to do all of the things she need to do. Basically, Kwame was saying that Africa need to grow up. Africa need to be the power that she can be. But since that time, Africa has been divided and it's been coming across weak and divided because the leadership is more concerned about what they can get, how much they can get, and what they can do to stay in power. But I believe God is changing that. I believe God is strategically causing that to change where there are some people that will not be in office much longer. You see, the fusion between great leadership and great management skills will determine the future of Africa. Let me say it again. The fusion between great leadership and great management skills will determine the future of Africa. God is waiting on Africa to make the turn. God is waiting on Africa to have the paradigm shift where the world will begin to see her greatness and her power. God is watching what is going on in Africa. He is ready to groom young leaders to make them to be leaders of the continent. God already has some of them that he's grooming right now. Young leadership with great management skills in order to take the continent, Africa, to her greatness. God is waiting on those old leaders to be able to understand that their time is up and that they need to come and recognize for Africa to survive, Africa need to be ran and led with great management skills from the young that are now coming up. God will always check management before he will release his power and resources. I want to say that again. God will always check management before he releases his power and resources. Well, what does that mean? If you're not managing the continent correct, if you're not leading the continent correct, if you're thinking about yourself, God will not release his power nor resources. The reason why Africa is losing, the reason why Africa appears to be weak and divided, and I believe she is weak and divided, is because the leadership want the power and resources without having true management skills. And since they don't have the management skills and leadership ability, they just go around in a circle. It's kind of like the hamster on the wheel. You see, management can be important, and God will not move on any prayers unless he can see that you know how to management. Because management will determine if God's prayers will get answered. So in other words, you can pray, you can talk to God, but if you're not managing correctly, your prayers will not get answered. So it appears to me that God is waiting on Africa to come to him with great leadership and great management skills in order to take the continent to where the continent needs to be at this moment in time. You see, the job of management is about the people. I want to say that again. The job of management is about the people. In fact, it's always about the people. The leaders in Africa must have a great management for and with the people. It is always about the people for leadership. Management of people is the primary goal of mankind. So if the leaders over in Africa, the presidents and all of those people that are in leadership position, managing the country, managing a different part of the country, as well as those leaders within the whole continent of the 54 and soon to be 55 nations, if they do not have great leadership nor management skills, then God cannot and will not move upon a continent or on a nation that refuse to allow themselves to have great management, great leadership with great management skills. Now, what does that mean? That means that many times those that are in those positions that don't care about the people will hold up the progress for resources and for God to move upon their mind to give them other things that they can do in order to make the continent flourish. You see, you must have great leadership. What does leadership says? Leadership says that I'm concerned about the people. You must have great management skills. What does it say? I want to manage the people in a way where they can progress. I want the people to see themselves moving forward. You must have great leadership. What does that mean? Write the vision down. Tell the people where we're going. Tell the people what we're doing. But if the people see that you're getting kickbacks and they see that you are a repressive regime and they see you're allowing people to get murdered and they're seeing that you're more concerned about your family, you're more concerned about what you can get, then the people feel that you don't care. So great leadership with great management skills is all about the people. So I say the continent of Africa need to focus on what is going on and what is happening to the people. Luke chapter 12, verse 48 says, for whosoever that is given much, much is required. God has given Africa, the continent of Africa, has everything that the world wants, have everything that the world needs, and have everything that the world has to have. God has given it to us as Black Africans who live on the continent, as well as Black Africans who live throughout the diaspora. But what we refuse to manage, we will fail to keep. Whatever Africa failed to manage, Africa will lose. Whatever Africa failed to manage, Africa will lose. God trusts in you and your management. He wants you to know that he's watching you. If you can't manage it, someone else will come in and manage it. God is ready to move on Africa, but not before he sees great leadership and great management moving to help the people of the great continent of Africa. And I would say, until that happens, Africa will remain the same or even be taken over by her enemies. It's important for the leaders of Africa, for the people of Africa, to select great leadership and make sure that that great leadership have great management skills. And if those leaders are more focused on themselves and focus on what their children can have and only focus on how much they can make, that is selfish leadership. That is not about the people. So I say this as I close. Great leadership through great management skills will turn Africa all around. The world is waiting on Africa to be where she needs to be, and she can only be that by having great leadership through great management skills that the continent can save herself. Until that happens, Africa will be taken over not only by the Chinese, Americans, and all the other countries, but Africa may be on her way to be colonized all over again. My prayer is that that will never happen. My prayer is that Africa will raise those young men, those young women, keep them from going to China for universities, United States. My concern is that Africa will raise up those great young leaders from 19 to 25, train them up to love their people, to love their continent, so Africa will save herself. And again, I say, through great leadership and great management skills, Africa can turn it all around. I hope you can receive it. I hope you can believe it. God bless. Until next time.